In this illustration, again, we'll study the steady state analysis of the given RC circuit. Here, we are required to find the charge on 3 microfarad capacitor in a steady state. So, here, we need to find out the potential difference across the terminals of capacitors, say these are A and B. Then, across this capacitor, to find out the potential difference, we need to first calculate the current in this 5 ohm resistance, then only we can calculate it by using KVL. So, to apply KVL in this circuit, we first distribute the current. Say here current flows I1, and in this loop current flows I2. So, if we write KVL equation for current I1, then in this loop we can write KVL equation as sum of the total potential drop across all resistances of the loop is equals to the total EMF. So, here we can write this is 5 ohm resistance, this is 10 ohm resistance, so total potential drop here will be 15 I1 minus 10 I2, because in this 10 ohm resistance I2 current flows in opposite direction. And this should be equals to the total EMF of this loop, which can be written as 20 minus 10, this will be 10. So, on simplifying this equation, here we are getting this as 3 I1 minus 2 I2 is equals to 2. Say this is our equation 1. Now, if we write KVL equation for current I2, see what we can write for this I2. The total resistance here is 20 ohm. So, for this we can write 20 I2 minus this 10 I1, because for this loop in this 10 ohm resistance, I1 current is flowing in opposite direction. And this equals to the total loop EMF, which is 20. On simplifying this, we are getting the equation as minus I1 plus 2 I2 is equals to 2. This is our second equation. So, from these two equations, on simplifying these, we get the value of I2. Here, if we add these equations, you can see we are getting 2 I1 is equals to 4. This implies the value of I1 we are getting is 2 ampere. And from equation 2, if we substitute the value of I1 as 2 ampere, this 2 I2 is equals to 4. This implies the value of I2 also we are getting 2 ampere. If we have got the value of current I2, here we can find out the potential difference across terminals A and B by writing KVL equation. So, here if we write KVL equation from A to B, then you can see what we are getting here. See, the potential at point A is VA, and potential at this point will be plus 20. And in this direction, if we move further, it will be minus 5 I2, which is 2 ampere. And this is equals to potential at point B, VB. So, simplifying this, we are getting VB minus VA is equals to 20 minus 10. This is 10 volt. So, as we have got the potential difference across the capacitor, we can find out the steady state charge in this 3 microfarad capacitor as CV. So, here its capacitance, you can see this is 3 microfarad, and the potential difference we already calculated as 10 volt. So, this will be 30 microcoulomb, that will be the result of this problem.